Hey, what is going on, guys? It is Young Childers here, and I'm back with another video. And today, guys, this is episode 5 and possibly the last episode of Subnautica. I'm not starting this video in the escape pod since I actually need to get a few things. I'm immediately trying to go out. Okay, I just went AFK for a few seconds and now this thing is chasing me. Oh my god, no, and this thing is super fast too, that's the problem. Why is this thing still chasing me? Why? And I do need to go back to the life pod for since I'm pretty sure there's a new audio thingy they left behind. I forgot the name of it.
Sunbeam? You know Aurora. We're from a little transgov on the far side of Andromeda, and we have a saying there. There's no bad without the good, no good without the bad. Sounds like you tasted a bunch of the former, but that only means you're overdue a whole lot of the latter. Might just be we're it. We're scanning for somewhere to park. We'll be in touch when we find it. Sunbeam out.
30 seconds.
I'm actually not 100% sure that place is radiated just like the ship. I still need to go over to the life pod.
Integrating new PDA data.
Okay, let's go. I have the third one.
Intake recommended. It is common for those accustomed to synthetic foods to be repulsed by eating an animal carcass. Remember that humans survived this way for millennia. You can too.
Thanks for the motivational speech.
Carry two of us?
Your regular sea glide tows a mass of 80 kilograms at over 30 kilometers an hour. The power cell rigged to this one should double that.
You think there's something out there that's faster?
Oh, sure. And that's assuming it doesn't overload 3 meters from the life pod.
You're calm about this.
I'm seeing the engineering problem. If I stop seeing the maths, I'll be terrified.
That's interesting because it doesn't look like their sea moth made it or their life pod. Also, I'm pretty sure they got attacked by a monster since they aerated in here. One thing I've been curious about for a while is you can kill these monsters with a survival knife since they move around really quickly. Another thing I've been curious about for a while is that cave, as you can see right here, right from me at this one, yeah. This cave, apparently it's blocked off by a rock, if you guys didn't know, like down there. Yeah, this rock right here. So I'm kind of curious how to get in, since I don't think I have the right tools, but I actually need a tool to get in. Not even gonna lie, I prefer this over the flare because my eyes can actually tolerate it. Because the flare was just too bright, colors were too contrasted, it was just horrible with the flare. Yo, what is that big squid thing? That thing looks, I don't even know. I don't want to go near it though. And it's right under the ship too, so that's going to be a problem.
Oxygen.
I'm still trying to look for anything useful, but I'm having no luck, just like a few episodes ago. Cause all I'm really finding is the same stuff, so it's not gonna help. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you like, subscribe, and turn on notifications for some more content and episode 6 of Subnautica. I'll see you guys in the next video. Goodbye.